Destroy! 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 Company! Destroy! 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 Company! Ross Purdy! Destroy! Company! Ross Purdy! Destroys! Company! Destroy! Destroy! Destroy Company! Ross Purdy! Destroy Company!
Wait, hey, 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 listeners, it's another week. It's another week of Ross Purdy Destroys Comedy. Sometimes I have comedians on, sometimes I have musicians on, and this week, it's a week where I have musicians on, because I'm like, fuck comedy, I don't care. It's called Destroys Comedy, I want to destroy it. It's not called Destroys Music. I want to fucking just hear about all the crazy music stuff, all the touring, all the band stuff, all the cliche biopic drug taking, all the just bottling people in the bar for not only paying you in beer cards. That's what I want to hear. So, of course, I've gotten members of a local Melbourne group called... I'm going to mess this up so badly, this introduction. I've been looking at me like, oh, please don't mess up this introduction. This is our big chance right now. Don't mess it up. Cold hands, warm heart. Hey, hi. Hey, introduce yourselves.
I'm Genevieve, and I play harp and synth and sing in the band.
Hey, I'm Esala, and I play drums and kind of percussive stuff.
Hey, don't feel too bad, Esala. Don't feel too bad. Ringo Starr played drums.
I love Ringo.
No one took him seriously either.
I know.
But he wrote Octopus's Garden, didn't he?
Yep.
And a classic, wonderful song.
Yeah.
We all know the name of, but couldn't pick it out if it was to come on right now. Or could you?
I reckon.
Could, yeah.
Oh, well. Of course you would know more than me. I am nothing but just a noob. It's internet slang. I'm a newbie.
Oh.
I'm a noob. What's music like? What is music?
What is music?
Does it bring the people together?
Yeah, definitely. It's like food, I think, you know. People react to it, whether they like it or not, you know. It's definitely changes the room and your brain chemistry. So I feel like it definitely, people are sensitive to noise, even if they don't actively listen to music, so.
Yeah. Right. Like, I sometimes hear songs and I just start gagging.
Yep.
Like, it goes anywhere near my ears, I just start gagging.
Oh, yeah, that's powerful, yeah.
I mean, my ears are gagging, that's the weird thing.
Yeah.
Like, vomit don't come out of there.
Yeah, the power of music, hey? Mm. It's wild. And I think it does, or it can, have a really, really positive impact as well. So not just the gagging of the ears to something you're not into, but when you're into music and that euphoria that can happen when you're either watching live music or listening to a track that you're just really into is unlike anything else, I think, in the world. And it's a wonderful... It's a wonderful thing.
I thought you were going to say, it's a wonderful life.
Well.
Which is a weird thing to bring up right now, I would say. You can cough into the mic. We're all coughing today, Jen.
I know. I think it's maybe the pollen or something.
There are so much flowers inside this studio. I just do not understand.
Oh, I think it was on the bike ride here, perhaps. Too many flowers. But, yeah.
I mean, that's really it, isn't it? too many flowers. I wish the government would do something about these flowers.
I think they are, right?
By doing nothing, you mean?
Yeah, I think they're going to just let it all burn, right?
Oh, man.
That's heavy.
We made ourselves sad.
Oh, it's meant to be comedy, Esala. It's meant to be uplifting. And we've taken
Look, you brought musicians into it. It's all about being depressing when you're musicians, right?
Well, yeah, there's the power of music and, you know, the wonderful thing that it is. And then there's being a musician, which is so up and down. Like you said, the being paid in beer cards. Or I don't know, just lugging a lot of gear a lot of the time. It can feel like a bit of a slog, but then there's those moments of glory or those moments when you feel like it's all worth it. And playing with other musicians for me is the thing I think that keeps me doing it. I love just that connection with people. It's awesome.
And we're like only half of the band. There's a bass player and a guitar player, but not here.
Well, they're not here, so they don't count in my eyes. Yeah. You two are here.
Yeah.
Yep.
You've done a podcast before? You've done interviews before?
We've done interviews, but not a podcast.
Right.
Have we done a podcast?
I don't think so. No, a bit of live to air stuff.
Yeah. So hopefully you can edit out all our snorting and our coughing.
No, I'm going to edit everything but that.
Yeah. No, great. Keep that in and add some reverb.
Yeah.
And just really highlight those moments and the awkwardness as well would be great.
Just us breathing into the microphone.
That is great.
Yeah.
Well, look, I've drank coffee into the mic a few episodes back. There's no professionalism here.
And yet it's a very professional studio.
It is. It's like I'm deliberately making a mockery of this studio.
Right.
So this is your first podcast.
Yes. Yep.
I just wanted to get you too comfortable and prep you up, do some media training, you know, just get you comfortable with being on a podcast.
Cool.
Just ask you some regular podcast questions.
Cool.
To just ease you into the podcasting world.
We're ready.
Yeah.
Does your feet ever go to sleep when you're on stage? Must be pretty bad because you're standing up, right?
As a drummer, no. But I've had like where I'm like losing my control of my foot because it's so like tired. And
yeah. I don't think I've ever had any limbs fall asleep while I'm playing on stage, but definitely that thing where you're like really like if my fingers are like harp playing is quite physical. And so if I'm playing like a really fast kind of riff or arpeggiator or something, and I get to this point where I just like can't really do it anymore, and then I have to kind of musically just change direction, or in like bad cases where I haven't been playing enough, and then I get like blisters on my fingers and then they start to bleed. And that's kind of intense.
Wow, that is punk rock.
That's harp shredding is what that is.
Harp playing is punk rock. Now, I never would have known that unless I got you two on. And I am learning just as much as you two are right now.
Sweet.
Via the medium of podcasting.
Wow.
Well, let's go back to the beginning. Let's go back to the very beginning. How did the band form?
Well, me and Jen have been in a couple of bands before, and then it just kind of grew into out of Jen's solo project, Genevieve and Jezebel, and then it just kind of became like a more of a band with Travis John, who's the guitar player, who's like, you know, pretty much then it was like three of us. You were like, we're a band now.
Yeah, I met Travis where I was studying music. We were in the same year doing a music degree. And I love playing with Travis because he's also a bit of a shredder. And so we can do this like harp, guitar, shredding thing together, which is one of my favorite things about the band. And so I was like, oh, you've got to, do you want to come play, you know? And he was like, yes. And that was the beginning.
Yeah. And he also doesn't play guitar like a regular guitar player, which is nice.
Yeah, he does it with his feet, right?
Yeah. Yeah, how'd you know?
Or his teeth sometimes.
Yeah. Right, okay. Didn't know about the teeth, but I knew about the feet.
Yeah.
Well, I did my research. I am prepared.
Yeah. I'm impressed. Yeah. So he's, a phenomenal guitar player, approaches it from every body part, as you've stated.
The nose.
Yeah.
The eyelashes.
The elbows.
The elbows.
Yeah. Sounds like it, doesn't it? Sometimes.
And that's how we formed. And then the bass player, Georgia, came a bit later because we didn't realize that a bass was a crucial thing. We were kind of just harp, guitar, and drums. And we did that for a little while.
And then we had a bass player from Japan, Yuko, who went back to Japan. And she can sing, and she could sing and play the bass, which was pretty amazing.
She's wonderful.
And also she played recorder, which now we don't have a recorder player. But
there
used
to be a lot more recorder in the band, unfortunately. Oh. It's not there as much now, but I'm really determined to play some more recorder. It's pretty wonderful, underrated instrument.
Yeah. I mean, you're evolving. You're going for a new sound. You had that recorder sound, but now you're going for that non-recorder sound. I mean, you're evolving and you just gotta let yourself evolve.
Yeah, that's also true. And it's great to keep, shifting focus and pulling in other instruments. I've just got a new synth, so that's going to evolve our sound in a different way.
Wow. Because you had exciting. That old synth sound.
Now there's the new synth sound, which ironically is an older synth than my other synth that I was playing. I've actually gone in reverse. I started with a modern synth, then I went to a 90s synth, and now I've got an 80s synth. So I'm just going back whilst evolving forward.
Is that what music is? Just going back?
I think it can be whatever you want it to be, It totally depends on where you want to take it. And that's the wonderful thing. You just work as a group to try and, make good sounds that you're all into. And that might be going back. It might be going forward. It might be going in circles. But, you just want to get it to a place where you all feel like it's something you want to share with an audience and that,
Now, I did shotgun mics something once, and I tried to go to a swamp, and I tried to record frog sounds.
Oh, awesome.
Because I thought that's where synth pop was going.
And it wasn't?
It wasn't going there. I think I was ahead of my time. That's what I like to say to myself.
Yeah, well, field recordings. I've just did some field recordings when we were filming our film clip, which is going to be for our first single off our next album. And I went and recorded frogs, cicadas, and lots of birds. We were out in Melbourne, which is a beautiful area. And that was, I'm trying to weave those sounds now into the track. So I think, you were ahead of your time. I think it's all happening now, Ross.
Yeah.
You got it. Maybe you should get those field recordings out and see what happens.
Yeah.
And also, like, the B-side to Kraftwerk's Autobahn has a whole synthesized frog sound / kind of water trickling. What else? There's weird animal noises, but made with synthesizers. I feel like that's a real, no one's really taken it up from there, you know. That was 1975. You're like right on the money.
Well, Kraftwerk, you know, they were always 50 years ahead of the game.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I tried forming a band once.
Oh, yeah?
I brought this up on a podcast. I listened to Fleetwood Mac's Rumours, and then I thought, oh, I want to make a band, you know, like Fleetwood Mac's Rumours. So, you know, I made a band, and I was trying to orchestrate the circumstances that Fleetwood Mac made Rumours in. So it was a lot of just drug taking, a lot of just trying to get people to sleep with each other. And now the music community don't like me.
Oh, no.
So, like, what's that all about?
Wow, I'm surprised. I thought that's what it's all about, being in music.
Well, they like to do it of their own free will. They don't like people trying to orchestrate them to go, hey, you should.
Yeah, why don't you?
You should go sleep with Stevie over there, Lindsay. Yeah. It's like, for the last time, my name's Tom. Stop getting me to clean everything.
Yeah, well, it's hard to get people to do, you know, do what you want them to do when you're in a band. I think you just got to pick the right people, and it just kind of, we're lucky, you know, we've kind of not really had any lineup changes in our band, since, apart from a bass player coming in and a wonderful new one coming in as well, you know. But yeah, you can just, I don't know, find the right combination, and before you know it, they'll be snorting cocaine and sleeping with each other just like you want it to be.
You can only hope. Yeah. You can only hope. Yeah. Okay, so we know how you came together, but how are you going to break up?
Oh.
You got to think about that now.
Start planning.
Yeah, got to start planning to break up right now.
Hopefully it's... we'll make lots of money and that'll come between us, and we'll have to live in different continents in large houses or something, right?
Wow.
That's a nice way to go.
Is that the 5-year plan?
That's kind of like...
Yeah, otherwise... Yeah, or we just kind of get really busy and we can't find a day to rehearse.
Yeah, I feel like that's more likely scenario. Yeah.
It's like, oh, I can't do Tuesday. Oh, I can't do Wednesday.
Yeah.
6 months later, you're like, oh, are we, yeah.
Yeah, it's all over. So, that'll be it, I reckon.
Yeah, that's, but, you know, I feel like I've been through pretty much every combination of band disillusion, right? I feel like less so in your case, Jen, but, you know, like, you name a scenario, I've been in a band that's happened to, I think.
Have you played a show at the big day out and everyone is going, oh, we're going wild, oh my god, whoa, we're going crazy, oh no. And then, you know, you inspire all this anger and all this sort of, stuff happens, and next thing you know, 15-year-old girl dies.
Wow. Oh. Yeah. No, that's... No. Thank God I haven't been in Limp Bizkit, but...
Yeah.
But yeah. I wouldn't wish that on anyone, really.
Yeah, that's brutal and horrible. The biggest drama...
Look, any band that has an album called $3 Bill, y'all, they should have stopped there, right there, you know?
Just stop making music, start making movies no one watches.
Yes. Yeah. Actually, funnily enough, Fred Durst has an Instagram where he just puts pictures of, like, old cars. That's probably Fred right now.
Yeah, that is definitely Fred. He's saying...
Oh, is he doing the Skyping?
He's just messaging saying, hey, I hear you guys. Please stop talking about me like that. So...
I don't think they've returned to Australia since then, have they?
Probably not. I wouldn't.
Not that I keep tabs.
I would probably reevaluate what I'm doing with my art, but hey, they kept going.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a Yeah, no, God.
But that hasn't happened to you. So you haven't been through every scenario.
No.
Caught you out in a lie.
Yeah, sorry. I just...
That was...
Must be all the cocaine.
Now, do you actually do cocaine? Because I have a feeling you don't.
No.
Catching you out in another lie. See, when you're on a podcast, you have to tell the truth.
I didn't see the disclaimer. Sorry, Russ.
You have to tell the truth. All the best things are about the truth.
Oh.
Look, I think the modern musician life is not as glamorous, and we were just trying to be cool, you know, just we're in this fancy studio. And
I just think modern musicians can't afford cocaine either.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a different world that we're living in.
I know, God.
For better or for worse. We're just trying to pay the rent.
Yeah, we just eat beans and rice every rehearsal, and that's... pretty much.
And then save all our dollars for the album, because making an album is super expensive.
Yeah, and then just hopefully in a couple of years everyone listens to it. Force people to listen to it, you know?
I mean, that's commercial radio, right? You get on that commercial radio, they'll be forced to listen to it.
Oh.
Over and over again.
Have we ever... No, they wouldn't be... No.
Mm-mm.
We're too weird.
Yeah. Unless recorders, like... harp, synths.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so weird.
I mean,
why are you so unconventional?
Planet did it, didn't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, that's we've actually missed our opportunity of cracking the mainstream, which was probably like the early 90s, unless Enya gives us a support slot.
I mean, that would be a dream.
Yeah. Can you make that happen?
I can definitely make it happen. I know all the people.
Fred probably knows Enya as well.
Yeah, he's got my number for some reason.
Get him onto it, and
wow.
So, cold hands, warm heart. Does for cold hands make it hard to play the instruments?
Yep, it does. I'm the one with the cold hands. It's pretty annoying. Bad circulation and all, but... Once you kind of get up there and you start, it's just a few minutes of warming up. And so we often start our set a little bit slow, the instruments kind of creeping in, and then we build it up. I definitely wouldn't go like with the harp all into those like hardcore shredding that I was talking about before straight away. I just couldn't hack it with my hands. But yeah, a little bit of a warm up. And then, yeah.
But you have to keep your hands cold throughout the entire set, because it's called cold hands, warm heart, not lukewarm hands, warm heart, or hot hands, warm heart, you know?
Wow. So really our whole lives are a lie, aren't they? Our musical persona, everything.
Really exposed us.
Yeah.
I mean, you know those flaming lips?
Oh, yeah.
Always on fire.
Yeah.
Doesn't look like it, but it can pull some, like, hologram tricks.
Mm.
But they're on fire.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I don't know. I don't know how we're going to solve this. Maybe we just need to change the band name.
We did walk past Wayne Coyne once. Coyne? Yeah. In a corridor once. The singer from the Flaming Lips.
Yeah, was that at Harvest?
We were like, oh, it's that guy. He's amazing hair.
Yeah, because you're so focused on the hair, you didn't notice that the lips were on fire.
Yeah, you know.
That's true.
That's how he does it, really.
Wow. Well, we just got to work on keeping our hands cold, I guess.
Yeah, you got it. Freaking
ice buckets.
Ice buckets on stage.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, we'll give it a go for our next gig.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like winter is our peak time. We get offered a lot more gigs in winter.
Why do you think that is?
It's winter music.
Got to keep the hands cold.
Yeah.
Yeah, totally. They're like,
makes more sense.
Yeah.
But does the warm hearts make it easier to write song lyrics?
I don't know. I feel like you know, this band name, which I have to confess I came up with, and it's pretty bad, but I'm trying to embrace it, and it just came from, like, being a kid, I won the prize. Like, the teachers at camp didn't know what prize to give me because I was just an average kid. Bit of an all-rounder. Nothing really stood out to them. So they gave me the award for the coldest hands and the warmest heart. And I was like, oh, it's kind of, is that all? That's all I got, you know?
Yeah.
And so I kind of always remember that. And so it's not such a literal thing. It's more like a kind of a nostalgia thing. And, yeah, I think, I hope most of our hearts are warm in that, you know, where feeling things and having empathy for each other and that kind of thing. And I, yeah. So does it help write song lyrics? I don't know. I guess because maybe it also indicates being alive, so that's helpful. And
gotta be alive to write songs.
Yeah. Well, yeah, yeah. Probably.
Probably. Yeah. I mean, you know, sure, Prince is writing a whole bunch of new songs, but that's Prince.
Yeah,
you're not at Prince level just yet.
Beyond human. Yeah. So, yeah.
Well, he's not a woman. He's not a man. He's something we'll never understand.
Yeah. Is that a Prince quote? Did you just quote Prince? Is that a song lyric?
Well, we're talking about Prince right now.
Oh, yeah, right.
I'm not quoting a song. I'm just saying.
All right, cool.
You know.
Oh, yeah, next question.
Okay, well, sometimes in podcasts, there is a lull in conversation, and you just got to ride it.
Oh, yeah.
Because people like the awkward humanity. Mm. They don't like the spit shine of show business. If they wanted that, they'll listen to Nova or something. And not and not some podcast that some guy just rented out a studio in Brunswick to do. So you just got to ride the lull.
Cool.
Just ride the lull. And part of riding the lull is hearing me say ride the lull. It's something they don't tell you in a podcast camp. Because there is no podcast camp. That's the lie.
Oh, I was going to say that sounds cool.
Nah.
So what's the world of podcasting like? Is it like Fleetwood Mac?
No, it's not, unfortunately. I'm in a rivalry with Joe Rogan. Some would say a one-sided rivalry, and he doesn't even know my existence, but I'm out to get him.
Yeah.
I wanted to call this podcast the Joe Rogan Experience, just to get those listeners. But then I got an email saying cease and desist, so I just had to change it to... What's the name of this podcast? Cold Hands, Warm Heart. That's the name of this show, right? Is that it?
You'll get a cease and desist from us. Well, actually, we can't because it's probably like someone else probably holds the copyright, so you probably get a...
Yeah, we definitely don't hold the copyright.
Yeah. We usually just abbreviate the name because it's one of those names that no one in the band actually... Say is it? We just, yeah.
So what do you call it? You call it heart?
Hey, hey. Catchy.
Yeah, heart.
It's
yeah.
a good one, isn't it? Yeah. Maybe we should try that.
Yeah, that's that worked for them.
I like to call the band Chua, which is how I pronounce the acronym. Then no one knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah, which, yeah.
It's like code, you know, Chua.
That's how you know you're onto something good.
Mm.
If no one knows what you're talking about,
yeah,
that's a good band name.
Yeah, that's genius, totally. Really, isn't yeah. it?
Yeah. And, you know, it's like, what is a band name anyway, you know? Like, there's so many bad band names and band names you get used to, like, you know, New Kids on the Block or...
What is that?
Totally.
They're old men now.
Yeah. Sonic Youth?
They're not Sonic.
They're not youth either, you know?
Yeah, but they're definitely not Sonic.
Yeah. So no one's going to pull them up on that. So it's like they've just... Yeah.
Yeah, I think you do kind of grow into your band name as well. If you stick with it long enough, or it becomes its own thing. Like, yeah, so many band names are kind of nonsensical, but once that band has established its sound in your mind, then you just associate those words with that sound and you love them or hate them or whatever. But, you know, sort of, it just becomes its own thing.
So what's this about a new album? You really releasing a new album?
Yeah.
Get to the plugs. Self-promotion. It's a part of the podcast world.
Excellent. We're working on our next album. So we've released one album so far in our careers. We're releasing it hopefully next year. There's still a bit of work to do. We've recorded the bed of the album, like all the instruments.
Yeah, we went to this little schoolhouse in Kerry that James Cecil has a recording studio there, and it's like this cute little schoolhouse that Jeff Kennett closed in the 90s, and so we could all like sleep in this giant bed, and then that's like on a little mezzanine level, and then come down and record all day for 3 days in this beautiful near Mount Macedon, and that was really cool. It was a bit intense because it was all in the one room, so there's like no, it's a very live sounding album. Like the last one we recorded in Tagati in near the Cathedral Ranges in Joe Talia's parents' farmhouse studio, and there was like a bit more separation, but this one is different, and it's like we're all in the same room playing together, which is cool. I feel like we're more of a band because we do that, you know. And then we're going to get Joe Talia to mix it, and he's in Japan. He lives in Japan mostly. And so it's that process of sending mixes back and forth at the moment. We've got a film clip coming out, because the last time we recorded an album, mixed it, which took like about another whole year of mixing, and then we put it out. We launched it in a warehouse that you can't advertise where it is, and you know, it was a great show. We had Mick Turner from Dirty Three on the bill, and it was like amazing. But we didn't do a film clip till the end of the year almost, which kind of people watch film clips and don't really, they take longer to listen to, you know, 35 minutes of vinyl than, you know, 4.5 minutes of YouTube. So we're gonna do it the right way around, I feel, this time. And put up a video. Slowly feed it to people.
No, you gotta force feed it. You gotta force feed that thing.
It's an 8 minute song, which
it's actually 10.
See, this 8-10 minute songs you're releasing. You gotta force feed it.
Yeah, well, it's probably gonna be about 4 or 5 songs because they're so long. No one's gonna.
Yeah, the songs are really long this time, so. You know, we're definitely, we're not trying to do the kind of conventional single route here.
We're hoping to get, it's straight, hopefully people will play it on radio.
Community. Basically, this film clip is like a mini movie. about 10 minutes, that's...
Is it really 10 minutes?
Well, I think it's almost 10 minutes. But
you don't even know how long your songs are. You're either really committed to playing it, and you don't know what else is going on.
Well,
you don't know what's going on in general.
It's, yeah, I'm the drummer. I just play.
You're right. And that's okay. It's okay to be a drummer. Ringo Starr was a drummer.
Yeah, I my kit is the same color as Ringo Starr's.
It's okay. It's okay. So it's okay to be a drummer. It's fine.
Yeah, thanks, Ross. Yeah. I need to hear that every day. As do all drummers, I think. Yeah. We might make it 8 minutes, maybe. It just depends on where you cut it.
Yeah. Our music has a lot of improvisation in it. So things can fluctuate in length. And that's maybe why we're having a debate about how long the song actually is. I think it's maybe it's in between. Maybe it's 9 minutes.
Well, play it safe. Say it's 20 minutes.
Yeah.
That way when it's like much shorter, you have a sigh of relief. Oh, good. We haven't gotten that self-indulgent.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, we're just building. This is only the second album. If we get to the third album, it'll probably just be one song.
Just one 70-minute song.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Now for the real business of why I got you two here. There's real business right now.
Sweet.
Christmas is around the corner. I want to make a Christmas album. So I thought, why not get a harp synth singer person and a drummer, and then we can just hash out a Christmas album for the ages. And I think of, like, what Christmas albums do we want to look to for inspiration?
Well, I loathe Christmas albums, but I do make the exception of Mariah Carey's Christmas album. That's pretty good, from back in the early 90s. And then Bob Dylan did a really wonderfully scary Christmas album.
Yeah, it is. It's have a you, bit creepy.
Have you heard that? I don't even know what it was called. There's a crazy film clip that he did, and where people just like have this manic party and one guy falls out the window.
Everyone's just drunk and Bob's just singing.
He sounds like an old snake just singing.
But that's about just Bob.
Santa and snowmen. It's quite bizarre.
Yeah,
like, it's quite, and you're kind of like, is this meant to be ironic? And I'm like, I'm sure it must be.
Yeah. It'll be scary as a child. Like,
oh, 100%. Or terrifying.
If you played, like, you know, I feel like Christmas albums kind of like almost like retail soundtracks, but I feel like that you wouldn't be able to sell anything with that playing.
Well, I think we need to look to the greatest Christmas album of all time.
Which was?
My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy by Kanye West.
Oh my God. Whoa. I never picked that up.
It was released very close to Christmas.
Really? Wow. Yeah.
I mean, when you think about it, Dark Fantasy. The Dark Fantasy of Krampus. Like the evil Santa who punishes for children.
Well, as a Kanye West fan, I feel like he is kind of like, you know, become
a Krampus type.
Yeah, totally. I'm struggling with his every move. Yeah, I long for the days of the early, of the 2000s. Yeah.
Okay, what else was it? All of the Lights. Of course, that's so obvious. How did you not pick that up?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The Power of the Lights. There's so many. I can go on here all day. But I think what we need to do right now is just get into that mindset. Just get into that mindset. And when I say we get inspiration, I mean just really rip it off. Because isn't that what inspiration is, ripping things off?
Yeah, I mean, I love the fact that he has so many... You might think you've peeped the scene.
You haven't. We gotta get into it. The watered down one, the one you know, was made... You know, this is actually Mrs. Claus. They made it sound all whack and horny. It sounds like Nicki Minaj doing a British accent, but it's actually Mrs. Claus.
Wow. You know, that this is a Roald Dahl. That Roald Dahl quote.
Higher on the sleigh. On the sleigh as we drop those presents. He's not hiding the fact that this is a Christmas album. Okay, okay, 3, 2, 1, repeat after me. No, okay, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. Christmas, 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 Christmas. Come on, Jen, you're the singer. Christmas. Christmas. Christmas.
Wow.
Come on, Jen.
I'm enjoying yours.
Christmas. Come on. Christmas, Christmas, Christmas. It's Christmas. Presents. Summer stuff. Christmas. Religious holiday. Come on, Jen. Back me up here. You got to do like the sort of hooks, the sort of... Hold on. Christmas, Christmas, Christmas.
I haven't even had a coffee.
Okay, we can you know, just loop that over and over again.
Yep.
Me saying Christmas, you saying I haven't even had a coffee.
Yeah.
Because isn't that like Christmas? You wake up early in the morning, you haven't even had coffee yet.
And you're there and family's there and
Kanye's there.
Kanye's there with his Christmas album and there's the tree and the dog's torn all the presents up and everyone's
Kanye's just
kind of
talking
at
you
other.
The whole time. And you get to sit next to Kanye and he just doesn't shut up.
But would you want him to? Unless he starts saying slavery is a choice again, then maybe like, shut up.
Or the Trump stuff is always a bit, makes me, my teeth itch, you know? Like, I'm like, Yeah.
If only he knew his words made our teeth itchy.
Yeah.
He would stop.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's what he wants, you know?
I think so.
How can you be shocking in 2020? Just, you know, apart from being an African-American guy who's supporting Trump.
That is so provocative. So provocative. He's just poking at the hornet's nest at this point.
Yeah.
Okay, we've laid down one track. Really disappointed with you, Esala. You did nothing. Jen added that sweet hook. That whole, I haven't even had my coffee yet. I feel like it really tied the song together.
Awesome.
We just, like, rinse, wash, repeat that in, like, the edit for the, like, 4 minutes or something. That's our single. Look. That's our lead single.
Well, it's pretty sick.
That's pretty good.
I loved your rapping there, the Christmas and all the presents, and it just really flowed, started to flow really nicely. I think we've really got something there.
I don't know if you noticed, but that was freestyle.
Yeah.
That was just coming out of my noggin right there.
It was sick.
It's like, I didn't even write that, like, S down. I can't say the S word because this is a Christmas album. We got to keep it pure.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Fam friendly.
Yeah, friendly for the fam. You can't say the Lee part. You got to save time. Because Christmas, you barely have any time. All right. This is the next track. We're going to do the next track now. Now, you two, I really want you to just get, like, into it. Just feel like, let's just say you're going to become, like, this impactful, just like wall that's just gonna attack. You're gonna attack. You're like this attack these like technologies, and you're just gonna like words are like swords, and you're gonna use those swords to cut the computers. And like, I hope that's good direction. I hope that's good, sensical direction.
It's amazing. I still can't believe your band didn't work out.
No, definitely not. Who could believe this band didn't work out? All right, this is going to be our next single. Christmas lights, lights of Christmas, lighting up on Christmas. Christmas lights gonna light up my house. I'm gonna get down and light up my house. And it's people driving down and it's dark at night. People looking at my house and look at it. All those lights, all these lights, all these Christmas lights, all these Christmas lights for the rest of your life, for the rest of Christmas. Christmas lights, got those Christmas lights. Nativity scene, lighten up. Okay, Jen, you do it. Okay, this is your verse.
Baby Jesus in the manger. Lots of lights all around. Lots of lights. Lots of lights.
Yeah, hit it! Esala! Esala! Christmas lights, Christmas lights, Christmas lights everywhere. Stringing up the lights on Christmas trees. People look at that tree and say it's lights up everywhere. Oh, look at those trees. Da, 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 da. Well, I'm going to count you in, Esala. I'm going to count you in. And when you do, you got to come in with something hot. Otherwise, I'm doubting your dedication to this project. Okay. Esala, 3, 2, 1. That wasn't you, come on.
Where's my coffee? Where's my soy latte? That should have been your line.
Okay, but
it's always your line on Christmas.
We want to think new ideas. We don't want to just rip ourselves off.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah. Look, it's tough. It's tough following you, Ross. You really got it. I don't think you need us.
You know what? I feel like you took all the best lines in.
Oh.
It's like, what about us? You taking lights? Dang.
It's
that is fair. Yeah. That is fair.
You did do a really good job of covering a lot of the Christmas. Yeah.
I feel like you prepared for that.
Themes.
That wasn't freestyling, was it, Ross?
No, you're right. I wrote all that down.
I knew it.
Dang.
Okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go back.
Oh no.
We're going to re-record. But this time I'm going to sit back and I'm just going to let you two just hash it out.
Hang on. Look, Ross. I got to say it's kind of unethical for you to ask a drummer to freestyle rap on your, you know.
Hey, that's... Ringo Starr could freestyle rap. He's very famous for that.
I think you're getting it mixed up with Paul McCartney, who guessed it on the Kanye track.
No, definitely not.
You know, he never asked Ringo to do anything. That's... There you see my point.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, God.
I'm just going to sit here in a corner. I'm not going to say anything.
I mean, I'm happy just to enjoy this. Yeah. Like, what an awesome hook. Like, how sick is this? If I could get my family to listen to this on Christmas Eve, particularly, I feel like it's classic. I'd have a much better Christmas, I reckon.
I'm not saying a word. I think Esala needs to do like the Rihanna hook. I'm not saying a word. Okay, I'm really doubting your dedication right now. I think we recorded something with Jen. She did some spoken word thing about getting people to listen to this song. We can layer that on there.
Sweet.
Okay. I really wanted to try this to make this work.
I mean, I did make a really cool sound in that last one of, like, freaking out. It was like a... You can use that.
I don't think it mic picked up.
What about doing some percussion? With your implements here that you have. I just get so overwhelmed by how good that music is. I just freeze. I can't do anything over the top of that. Actually, I think Asla's probably feeling the same.
Look,
I'm very powerful.
I feel like freestyling with words, like you were saying the other day, it's like improvising with an instrument is so much different to improvising words, because it's like you're using a whole different neural kind of pathway for that. Especially with, like, I feel like I've never, like, you know, written poetry or anything like that. It's like, yeah, or like ever sung, you know, band, even backing vocals, you know. So it's just like always a bit, oh my
God. It's really hard. So we've got an improv gig next week as band. At the Make It Up Club, which is an awesome Melbourne institution. It's been going for
25
years.
Yeah.
At Bar Open every Tuesday night. You can get along there and see wonderful musicians improvising. But at rehearsal, we rehearsed for the improv. We just had a jam. I was saying I can't improvise singing, really. I would have to have words written down, and even then it's really, really, really hard. It's just so much easier to play an instrument, because, singing or even just speaking over the top of music is, I don't know, it's just so much more challenging. Words are so loaded as well, like.
So loaded.
You can't, I don't know. It's too hard for me. And then we've just demonstrated that it's probably would be too much
for Ringo
over here.
Look, Ross, I'll come back and rap if Ringo gets a guest on the next Kanye album.
That could never happen.
Wow.
I'm shocked. There you go.
There you go.
Wow.
Yeah.
Ringo can still play.
Possibly. Okay, I want to lay down this one last cut.
God.
We're not going to get anything out of you two, so maybe you can just click in the background or something.
Okay. Oh, yeah, do some percussion.
Yeah.
Do some percussion with the empty bottle. There you go. Just smack your glasses onto the bottle. The song is dedicated to you, Esla.
Oh, thanks.
It's Esla's fault. Esla's fault. If I was to blame someone for this not working as well as I'd like, it'd be Esla. He contributed nothing. Not part of the Christmas spirit. He didn't contribute at all. He just claimed he made a weird sound. It's all Esla's fault. It's all Esla's fault. I'll say it's all Esla's fault. Da 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 da. It's all Esla's fault. Da 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 da. Maybe Jen, if you wanna do some harmonizing. Jen's not doing anything anymore either. I thought she was the one on my side. But now I blame both of them. Da, 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 da. Not very Christmassy at all. It's not Esla's fault. Not very Christmassy at all. It's not very Christmassy. Not very Christmas-like. Not very Christmas. No, not Christmas at all. And then, okay.
Wow, I don't think I've ever been sung to on radio. That's amazing.
Ross, you're so good at this.
Yeah.
I think that you need to pursue this because you're great at kind of off the cuff, or whether you've sort of pre-prepared a little bit, I'm not sure, but it's really, you know, you've got it.
Yeah,
you've got what it takes.
Start a band with Kanye. That's what was missing.
I was going to say.
And Fred.
Oh, no, don't.
For Durst. For Jinx.
Is that your band name?
For Jinx. yeah, it was. So what was missing was me just monotonously saying things to like off-key tune of Kanye West instrumentals off YouTube. Was that what was missing?
You know what? You could probably get a gig at Make It Up Club next year.
Next year?
Yeah.
Well, I'm thinking about New Year's resolutions. You know, it's a silly season. My New Year's resolution is to never go to the Make It Up Club, which is weird because today is just the first time I've heard of it.
Oh. Well,
but I've been thinking about this resolution for a very long time.
Well, luckily we're playing next week, so you can still go follow. That can be the one and only time you ever go to Make It Up Club.
But I refuse to do it.
But it's...
Here's what I don't refuse to do. So, you two got anything to plug?
This gig we're playing
that okay.
You're refusing to come to, which is...
Yeah, but what's the date?
17th of December.
Okay, well, that's past.
Yeah.
I'm holding up a newspaper right now. It says December 23rd.
Oh, right. Well, it's... I can feel an awkward silence coming on.
Yes, but remember what you learned. Ride for lull.
Oh, yeah.
So other than that, what have you learned on your journey?
Today?
Oh, on music or whatever. I forget how I do this.
What have I learned? Oh. Wow, you're asking me all the hard questions today. Over to you, Jen.
I have learned just to kind of keep going with, this is going to sound real cheesy, keep going with doing what you love and trying to make the best art you can, even if it doesn't always feel like it's working or whatever, just keep at it and enjoy it, and that music is, I couldn't live my life without music, so yeah, I'm very grateful to have it. I'm actually, I think the longer I've been doing it, the more grateful I am to have it as an expressive form, but also as a way to connect with people, being like my bandmates, and to connect with other people, being the audience. It's really awesome, and I do think music can save the world.
Yeah, you know, I feel like I listen to music so much. I play music every day. I talk about music all the time. Yeah, I feel like I just wouldn't connect to anyone if there was no music. I'll just live in a cave.
Well, which I already do.
Oh, awesome.
So what you're saying is I need music.
Yeah, I think, yeah. Get Fleetwood Mac back together.
The Jinx.
With Jinx.
That was the name of my Fleetwood Mac band. Keep up with this made-up lore.
Look, with a name like that, it's just going to go...
Not going to jinx myself. Yeah. That's where the name came from. I'm not going to jinx myself. I'm not going to be the Jinx.
Yeah, I wish we thought of that name.
But you haven't. All right. See you later, everybody. Merry Christmas. Ross Purdy presents Kanye West's My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy of a Christmas. Might be coming out next Christmas. I need to make at least 2 more songs for it to work. Jen Esler, thank you for coming on the show.
Thanks so much for having us, Ross.
I wish you all the best for the warm, cold, heart of my hand club. Did I get it right?
Yeah, it's perfect.
Yeah, that's the new name.
Ross Purdy, that's Thor's Covenant!